There you go. That was double your house for half the money. Have we got a picture?
We've got a final viewer's pet pick. This is Clifford from Dublin, who loves fancy glasses.
Oh, let's have a look.
Strange,
isn't it? You got a pet. You didn't have a pet, do you? No. You had a dog back in Ireland.
Well, I know. I used to have two pigs. For some reason, my godmother decided that I wouldn't want money for my communion. She got me two pigs. And we named them Rasher and Sausage.
What were they...
They were massive.
Did they come inside or were they just out in the garden?
No, they came out in the garden.
Did you grow up on a farm or was it...?
Just sort of in the middle of the countryside.
Oh,
the
right.
Gardens were slightly bigger.
So you had land to put them on. It wasn't like a
terrace. Well, they weren't in a pet. No, they weren't. No, they weren't on our terrace. No.
You could put a pig in your back garden, couldn't you? There's a miniature ones. Oh, I mean, you could never go out there. It would just be.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You could keep a pig in there.
Yeah. For what reason?
Bacon.
Oh, okay.
All right. So we're gonna make macaroons. Do you cook, Katie?
Kind of. I'm not fantastic. I've tried macaroons before and they never work.
You tried making macaroons
before? Yeah,
about
2 weeks
ago. Well, that's someone who cooks a lot.
There we go, yeah.
Macaroons.
Because they are tricky. They absolutely are.
So you bake or you...
Yeah.
So what's your signature dish?
Depends. I make a lot of them. I make cookies for the crew in work. So I bring those down. Sort of chocolate chip. Just basic stuff. This all sounds like it's much better than it actually is, really,
right,
honestly.
Okay.
Very basic.
So you're not going to compete on Celebrity Great British Bake Off?
I love the British Bake Off. It is, in fact, the best show on TV, other than Merlin.
Hold on.
Other than this show as well.
Do you want to come back on?
Yeah, exactly. OK, so this is what we've got for it. We've got some ground almonds, we've got some peanuts that we've roasted and we've broken them down, a little bit of vanilla, some icing sugar, and then we're going to fill them with peanut butter and mascarpone, so it's a double peanut butter hit, OK? Then we've got egg whites and sugar. So first job we're going to do, tip into our processor.
What's amazing about the Bake Off is as I've done a lot of baking with Simon over the last 5 years, and it's all pretty much the same in a way, isn't it? Really,
the principles are similar, absolutely.
And yet you sit there and watch them do the same things, don't you? And it's captivating television.
Such drama. Is it going to be a good bake? Will there be a soggy bottom? I don't know.
I think they never address the farination problem on that program. At the end of the day, if they address farination, then it would make it.
Right.
So we've put all this. What we want, actually, the reason that we've done this, I should have explained, is to make this nice and smooth.
Okay. That's
really important. So we've broken it down as much as we can, but there's still more work to do.
Okay.
So Katie, what we need to do, and this will put a little cloud above you, is basically work this through the sieve a little bit. So it's kind of a double action of shaking it like that and also working. Because basically there'll be little bits of peanut in there.
Mm-hmm.
If we don't get rid of those, then you'll end up with a mix that won't pipe very well.
Okay.
That's what's very, very important. Okay. And macaroons, they are a tricky thing to do.
Really
There's
hard.
There's no two ways about it. And, you know, they're very easy to get wrong. I think that's the thing. They're not that difficult to make, but dead easy to get them wrong.
Because when I make them, it all seems to be going very well until I try and take them off the paper. And then they just won't come
Can
off.
Can I say something at this stage, which is not being rude, but macaroons always look nicer than they taste. Is that a fair thing? You know what I mean? They look like they should
until
be...
Until today.
Until today.
Yeah. I know what you mean, though. Sometimes they taste a bit papery.
But they're such fantastic colours.
Yeah.
And you think, are they going to... And then they're kind of slightly bland sometimes.
Do you think it's a bit like fruit teas?
Yes.
The smell of a fruit tea is always lovely.
Or even the label. You go, oh, that looks good.
Yeah.
Yeah, raspberry and horseberry or something.
But,
I don't know. Made up berries. And you go, yes.
Yeah.
And it just tastes of water, hot water.
Yeah. Smells nice, but actually doesn't taste fancy at all. I always think that with them. Which is why beer and wine are always a good thing to drink, because they always taste delicious and smell
and
lovely
smell
as well.
Good.
Beautiful. So, these are the bits that we're talking about. So it's that's important to get rid of, because otherwise they will give us too much weight and they'll give us too much texture, which isn't what we want. So, Tim, would you like to whisk up the sugar and the egg whites for me? So what we've got, this is now sort of the meringue side of it, really. So the egg whites and most of the sugar is in there. I put a bit of vanilla in. In goes the sugar. And this then gives us the base. So these two things combined, this is kind of the tricky bit, really, if you like.
Okay.
And probably one of the other things that's gone on, apart from them kind of sticking on your parts, which is probably, that'll do you, Tim, for our purposes. In reality, you'd actually kind of whisk that for much longer. So they're quite voluminous and very, very stiff. what you get two separate things happen. If they stick to your parchment, one, it might mean that you didn't cook them quite hot enough, and the other might be that you had old parchment, because it does dry out. Oh, so then we try and get it off.
So it wasn't me being useless. It was my utensils were wrong.
See, you're only as good as the implements you've got, to be perfectly honest. So this is now we've got the sugar and we've got the you see, this is still a bit sloppy, so you'd have it stiffer than that in reality. So what I need to do now, this is all folded through. So all of that goes in and simply fold all of that together like that. So it's a gentle yet speedy process.
Gentle yet speedy.
Okay.
Now, I read before the show in minutes that you worked with Madonna.
I did.
What did you do with Madonna?
I was in her film W.E. about Wallace Simpson and the King of England.
She directed that, didn't she?
She did, yeah.
And wrote it, or...?
Yeah, she did. She wrote it and directed it. You know, she's a woman of many talents.
And what was she like to work with? You hear so much about her, don't you? She's got to be the most famous woman in the world.
Yeah. It's weird. It's one of those things that everybody wants to know, no matter who I've worked with. She's the one person that always comes up. And I think everybody wants me to say that she was horrible, but she was really lovely.
Right.
She was really nice to me. She was very professional. She's a real actor's director. She loves sort of, you know, actors and chatting to them. And you know, it was a really great experience. And then at the end of the day, it was Madonna. And you're sort of standing there with Madonna, and it's very cool.
And the first time you met her, was it embarrassing? How did it happen?
The first time I met her was in her dressing room. She came in, and I auditioned for her with the girl who ended up playing my sister, and they cast a supermodel as my twin sister, which was always fun. Woo! And all of us just sort of lying on the floor of her dressing room during the audition. So not only do you have to, like, meet Madonna, but you have to, like, get down personal with her on the first time. It was really odd.
Were you more nervous about doing the audition or meeting Madonna?
You know, I wasn't that nervous about meeting Madonna.
Right.
I think I probably should have been, but maybe that's what sort of worked well in my favour, you know?
So... You've been starstruck, too.
Only when I meet old footballers, like... I remember Kevin Keegan saying hello to me and I went bright red. Ray Wilkins, Kenny Dalglish, those ones, the legends.
OK, so here's what we do. So now this is our batter, and basically then all we do, Katie, is simply you've got to make sure this is nice and tight, and you just go straight down like that, pull it off and do that.
Okay. Mine totally didn't look like
so
this.
So basically, it's about speed, dexterity.
Why do you have to go quickly?
Well, really, because otherwise what will happen is they'll start to stick. So the batter will... See, you're getting kind of little kind of nipply effect on the top, but if you come off really quickly, then that'll... OK, so then we bake those for about 10 to 12 minutes, and this is what we end up with. So these are our beautiful little macaroons. And then this is simply mascarpone cheese and peanut butter, and we put a dollop of that in the middle. So this gives you that double peanut butter hit. And then once you've got that on there, we simply sandwich them like that. And they look pretty. I mean, you can if you want. They'd be quite nice to have a little bit of thin raspberry jam on there. Would be beautiful as well, which would work really, really beautifully.
Okay. So have... Remember, in just a couple of minutes, Tim Burgess is going to be singing for us.
There we go. So
that's about a minute's time. But would you lot like to try those, please?
Go for it.
As your... Let me have one as well.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's a real big kind of...
Oh, yeah.
It's a big peanut butter hit. You know, obviously, our peanut butter's a little bit soft, so what you do is you want that a little bit harder, really, so it just goes, but you real kind of... If you don't like peanut butter, you're going to hate them. If you like it, then it's a double hit.
I like that. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I've got some tweets coming. Stacey.